This is Sherry Brutz again. It's June 2018. Yesterday, after I told you about the evil powers here trying to take me over, they did their usual thing. They said I was going to have a severe headache and migraine because they were going to adjust my brain, and that they said I wouldn't be able to get out of bed. But I got out of bed, but all night long they attacked me ferociously. They burned the two front lobes, and they're not lobes, but these two areas in my brain all night, to where it hurt to touch this area, like baked from the sun, real bad sunburn. Well, they said they were gonna make me have like droopy eyelids, and they showed me a picture of my eye shut, like it's gonna be permanently damaged. And then they showed me pictures of my eye like falling out, and all this like stuff supposedly draining out of like a river or something flowing through my being by destroying my eye. This is my only good eye, and they've destroyed it. This eye, the damage they've done this year went from 2020 to like 20, I think they said 75. This is the only eye I'm gonna have left. This was my only good eye because I was born with a lazy eye, and I've had to see all doctors since I was like kindergarten. And I used to have to wear glasses and a patch all through elementary school. You know, so they're picking areas that they knew I had weak. When I was little, I had a bad back. I was born with scoliosis, and then I was hit by a car, and then somebody fell on me and broke it in two. And I would have been paralyzed if somebody hadn't got them off me after I was halfway bent over. I was a child playing a board game. I wasn't even a teenager. But they're picking areas for some reason that I already have problems. So it's like they want to pick pre-existing things, so then when they destroy you, you think it's natural causes. Going blind is not natural. If you look at all these illustrations they're putting out now, there's people with one eye or no eye. There's even Susan Lucci's in some kind of ad with a patch on her eye, and a lot of celebrities now are wearing patches on their eyes. It's not just pirates or Illuminati symbol. I think it's a symbol for like something to do with evil, you know, the evil eye or blinding someone, you know, like an eye for an eye. It's something symbolic, I think. So then they said they've been showing me for a few months how they're destroying the muscles in my face. They've been doing that for a year now, and they've shown me diagrams of how they're attacking each one at night, and they're doing it with these weapons. And then after they attack them and my skin starts getting loose, it never was before, it was firm a year ago, and they're making my eyelids droop, then they tell me what plastic surgeons to use. One's in Las Vegas, one's in Beverly Hills, and then they tell me I'm gonna need plastic surgery, and they tell me that they're giving me jaws and how to have those taken away, exercises. It's all satanic torture. It's all ridicule, humiliation, because I totally see the light. I so totally see these idiots. I so totally see how they're destroying the world for the Antichrist. I see what fools they are. You know, after they attack me, you feel so mentally impaired. You know, it's like sometimes my eyes will just spin like I've had brain trauma. I've had brain trauma in car accidents. You know, I've been knocked out and things like that. I know what brain trauma is. But when they attack my brain and tell me they're giving me a lobotomy every time I get a little bit of strength or self-confidence or I feel some ounce of human worth, they do it again like last night. So last night, they were attacking me to where I couldn't use my left hand. I couldn't make it work. I didn't think I'd ever use it again. They were attacking the nerves, and they said they can permanently damage them where I won't be able to use them. So today, I had to go get dog food at PetSmart, and this is the first time ever that three times I kept dropping the cans out of the bag. I couldn't hold the cans. And then my hand that did get some feeling back, it just kept going numb on me, giving out on me, trying to drive. It was just gone numb. And they're doing this for fun, for just entertainment. But you know, I know there's a devil here, and I know all this is unnatural, and everything that is satanic goes against human nature, and everything that's the Antichrist is an abomination for hell, destroys us. They are destroying us. You know, what kind of fools in this world that know anything about the Bible or the Ten Commandments would embrace such an evil force? For one thing, you're human, and they've replaced you with machines and technology. And the things that they're trying to do to me are inhabit my mind through some spiritual entity or devil and actually communicate with me telepathically to try to get me to take commands. And as soon as I free myself up, they start attacking my brain to where it's like a concussion. And then all I want to do is just try to fight sleep. And they kept me sleep deprived for years, years and years, so that I would be weak enough that they think they could get let themselves in. And that's why you see all these ads out, let me in. They don't need you. They want your kids. They do not need you. They want to raise people in a slavery environment to where they think they're happy with their domain because they don't know any difference. They can take all your kids. They're building all these Disney theme parks with these Nazis and these pedophiles. And they just want to feed off the young, train a new world to believe all this devil bullshit, do away with the Bible, and just totally infiltrate your mind. They don't want you to be a body without their demons. They want your body to take commands through their demons and perhaps aliens. And they're running the world right now. You know, you've all kicked God out of your world. And all this time, they've been replacing all the godly things with satanic things, statues, everything. I know that when I'm fighting this force, it's powerful, but it's taken over the whole world. And as I was driving in my car today, and I was feeling like I just kept wanting to just sleep because of what they did last night, and I had to fight it because it's like having a brain operation or something. I just kept remembering I was a child, and my favorite songs were Simon and Garfunkel song, Cuando Paso, about flying away, always wanting to fly away. And I was a kid, I always had the urge to want to fly away. I love my family, I love my home life, but I've always had this spirit that wanted to get out of this body. But now that I've started getting used to the world and loving people, I want to stay for that reason, because I love people. But as I was going down the road thinking of my old youth, thinking, oh, I miss the days that I flew away in my mind and my spirit, my soul felt like it was flying away. And instantly this group knew. They know, they can monitor my brain, and I started just getting really sick and everything. And they call themselves the eye in the sky. You don't believe these weapons are supernatural, but until you become a victim. But once they have you in what they call the matrix, you will see that I think they can even somehow confine your soul. And how I know is after I bought a ticket to Russia, somebody here told me, you're never going to be the same, and you're going to have to go in the woods and find your soul. I didn't know what they meant. And then they said, come back to me, like, be my possession so then I can kill you. We can be in hell together. And they tell me this all the time. And I'm like, get the hell away from me. You know, trying to contain my mind and something. They took something. But then yesterday I realized that it was me. It was me. Somehow they've taken the biggest part of me, because for a few hours yesterday when I took some pictures, the old Sherry came back that was really like my soul. I could think like I did in high school, and I had feelings like I did when I was young, and I felt strong. I felt so strong and capable and confident. And as soon as they found out, they attacked me all night long. This evil power wants your body, wants full control of your mind. It doesn't want you. And it's hard to describe something I don't know, but I think somehow they're trapping people's souls, or they're putting them in something, something, and they're detaching you from your own identity, and they're stealing your thoughts, and they're trying to get your secrets, and they're invading your personal life and recording everything you do, including when you're in bed with your husband, and taking pictures of you don't even know about. All this is just being set up to destroy humanity. And all I can say is, what kind of person wants to be in this world? Why would you want to have babies to be controlled by machines and technology? Humans weren't meant for this. Can't you open your brain and see this is all the work of the devil? It's the devil to destroy mankind. And somehow these people have let the demons in their minds build these weapons and technology to destroy their own race. This is so real. And they're killing me because I'm fighting this with everything I have. They know I'm one of these people that can feel it and fight it. and warn others. But I can't defeat it because it's the Antichrist.